1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to have some fun. We got an old cap pistol we're going to restore and have a shootout down at the OK Corral. So let's get on down to the shop and check it out.
Recently, I put out a little picture on Instagram of an old-timey cap gun. And lo and behold, I was at the flea market this weekend, just a couple of days later, and I found this. An old-timey cap gun. Looks a lot like the other one that I had, with a nice engraving on it. Many of us had these as kids. And one of the viewers wrote in and said, the words we all used during the gunfights were, "I got you." No, the other one said, "I got you first." And then back and forth, "I got you first." No, I did. This went on every day. We had these battles constantly. I recently found that caps are available, so I'm going to find some caps for this cap gun. It's in good working order. The little lever that pushes up the roll of caps needs a little cleaning because it's a little stiff, but everything's in good shape. It's got a name on it here. See if we can read it. I can't quite make it out, but we'll get that cleaned up. And we're also missing the handle. So we're going to make a handle for this. Get it cleaned up, get it working, and see if we can find another kid to have a gunfight with. Here I am with my little brother in about 1950. I was dressed up as Roy Rogers, and he, of course, was Hopalong Cassidy, carrying our dual six guns. And here we are getting ready for the big shootout. Okay, before we continue, remember we're in this woke world where there are no kids with guns. There's no cowboys and Indians. The word boys doesn't exist anymore. And God forbid you should talk about Indians. There are no cops and robbers because cops aren't the good guys anymore. They're the bad guys. And the robbers are let free to run the streets. Oh, in addition to that, the word cowboy, you can't even talk about cows anymore because they're on the green bad list. They admit gases that pollute the world and that bad old beef, you shouldn't eat beef. So it was a lot more fun then without all those crazy restrictions now. How are kids supposed to go out and have any fun nowadays? Beats me. Okay, where are we on this silly little cap pistol toy project? I can't tell you how. This has been harder than almost any tool I've ever done. Why I took it on, I don't know. I built a handle here. As you can see, there's four layers of quarter-inch plywood. It's going to be painted, so it'll be sanded and finished and all the cracks filled and everything before it's painted. The reason I ended up with these layers, there was a piece of metal that formed the inside of the handle, and it was offset. It came down, this second piece, so it came down on this side. It wasn't in the middle. It was to the side. So I had to have a side here, two middle pieces, and the side over here. The two middle pieces are not solid pieces because all the handle and part of the trigger spring mechanism went down into here. So these pieces were cut. They looked like this outer piece. And then I went back and cut the whole inside out of these pieces. So they would fit over the metal handle. I don't know if I'm explaining that right. Over the metal handle that came down in here. So these two pieces in the middle fit over them. And then was sandwiched with two outer pieces. What a heck of a project. Why I do this to myself, I don't know. I thought this would be fun and quick. But I don't know. I'm having fun. I'm creating something. The handle is not quite like what I wanted. I wanted something a little wider, but I'm where I am. I'm not going to redo the handle. That was many, many, many hours worth of work just to get to here. So I'll have to do some filling and then sanding and smoothing and painting. For the color of it, I thought, well, I'll probably go with a pearl white. Remember the old pearl handled revolver, if I can find that paint. Maybe over at the craft store, a pearl color. If not, I'll see if there's some other color that might fit it, but that seems to be what's right for it. It wouldn't look good stained because it's just a piece of plywood. Actually, it's too many layers. All these lines would show. So we're going to round this off a little more, smooth it out, fill the hole, fill all of these cracks, do a little shaping, do some painting, and by the time I get that done, as long as this is taken, I ordered a box of rolls of caps. We're actually going to have a firing with the regular old red strip caps. And as you can see, everything is working. The mechanism that pushes the caps up along in here, you can see it's moving. So the cap should come off of here and push up into the flat area here to where this hammer will strike it and fire them. So that's my thoughts. We'll finish it up and be back with a little show and tell on the finished tool and a little shootout. Okay, the cap gun is finished. Time to look at the results. Here's the handle. Finished out in its pearl color. I mixed some paints to come up with that I didn't have a pearl white. It turned out pretty good. The handle is not, well, first of all, I'll show you the whole thing here. See, I put a little decoration on it here. A lot of them had a little silver doodad on it. Give it a good look. I couldn't find exactly what I was looking for, so I used something you don't see much anymore. It's called a dime. That's real money. That's what real money used to look like. It still looks like it, but it's hard to find. Anyway, it turned out to be the right little accent piece on here. Looks good. The handle, again, ton of work, but it came out nice, and it's really working. The tool looks very nice. Now, I made this handle just by what I do. I didn't draw a plan, and I didn't take the time to go and look up an old six gun to see what the handle looked like, and unfortunately, the handles were a little wider at the base here. It was a little different. My bad for not looking, but it's done now, and it's more of a modern type grip than the old six-shooter grip, but by golly, I think the little gun looks good, and it feels good. Fits a hand, does just fine. This is where it opens, and there's some caps loaded. Now I'll tell you about the ammunition for this gun. Okay, the caps, the ammunition, the little cap pistol have arrived. I bought 1,200 shots. I think I paid around $15 for this delivered. So this is what they look like. Look a little different than the ones that I used to shoot, or I remember, but that was a long time ago. It was a roll of paper, and each little dot was, I'm assuming, a little dot of gunpowder. I don't know if it's the same thing today, but it would bang and burn and smoke, and 1,200 shots. Uh, got some warnings. I think we ought to read you the warnings. First of all, on the outside, it says, warning, choking hazard, small parts, not for children under 3 years old. Safety rules for all caps. Never point or shoot at anyone. You got a toy cap gun, that's what you do. Never point or shoot at anyone. Do not fire closer than 1 foot to the ear. Hold gun at arm's length when firing. Unload gun when not in use. Store ammunition separately from gun. Treat every gun with respect. Never carry caps in pocket, or as cap may ignite and cause burn. Do not remove caps from their package. Do not remove them from their package. Okay. Do not remove caps from their package until ready for use. Caution. Use only under adult supervision. Boy, modern world today is taking all the fun out of being a kid. Anyway, here they are. Let's load some up in the little cap pistol and try them out. Here's how they load. The roll of them goes in here and they roll around and come up to this area here where the hammer comes down on them and it hits them and strikes them and makes them go. Again, these were the original caps that I bought, and they worked terrible. A little bitty poop, beep, 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 not much of a noise and not much of anything. And then I found these, and these are the old Tommy caps, what I was looking for. Kilgore brand perforated roll caps for all repeaters. No safety directions of any kind on here, unlike the other ones I showed you. It just says roll caps. And here's another one called Bang Caps, made by the same company, Kilgore. And the difference here, they didn't have the perforated holes. This is how they came in the box. This one had four rolls. I took one off and put it in there. You peeled off each one and used it, each one holding 50 shots. And the ones that had the little holes in it, some of the guns had a little bitty pin that went around, and the caps rolled on those, and it pushed it up into it. This one is a force feed. It just forces it up there with a little lever. You can see the action there with the lever pushing on it and pushing the hammer back. And this one didn't have the holes in them. Both of them were working this gun, so we're ready to go with some shots here. But it's interesting to note, like I said before, the tons of safety precautions on the original one, which included, do not point this at anyone. Well, hey, you're playing cowboys and Indians, you're playing cops and robbers, you're pointing your cap gun at the other person, you gotta shoot them. Time for the sights and smells and views from yesteryear. Time for a gunfight, boys and girls. Smell that smoke. Yeah, that was a good playtime. That's what our fun was all about. The six gun just works great. Shoot 'em up, cowboys. Thanks for watching the video, partner.